everyone, and welcome to Art Doctor Quickies, where we take an in-depth yet brief look at one work of art. Today, it's one you've seen before, Angelica Kauffman's self-portrait of the artist hesitating between the arts of music and painting. That is, you've seen it before if you've seen my video on five classical women artists you should know, and there I explain what a badass Kauffman was. But today, let's take a closer look at this wonderful painting with an unusual subject. Kauffman has painted herself as a young woman, dressed in white, a color of innocence and youth, choosing between two very separate passions, music and painting. Music, with a score resting on her lap, holds Kauffman's hand and implores her to stay. Her red dress and golden belt are reminiscent of the opulence of the stage. However, the flowers in Music's hair tell us that her efforts will be in vain. Ivy symbolizing fidelity and friendship, and morning glories symbolizing extinguished hope. For the young girl has chosen painting, gesturing to her with an open hand. Painting, dressed in a spiritual blue with her artist's palette and brushes at the ready, wildly points to a small classical temple on a far-off mountaintop. The temple seems to glow. It is glory incarnate and symbolizes the intellectual and creative freedom of a career in painting. Kauffman looks at Music with sadness and resolve. Though she's tempted to play it safe, she has to go for it. Though only a young teenager at this point, Kauffman was very good at both music and art. And, you know, she also spoke four languages, but whatever. She played the cello and had an amazing soprano voice. She also was a virtuoso in drawing and painting. So she really could go in either direction at a time when the words woman and career hardly came together at all. There is a story written in one of her early biographies about how torn she was deciding between the two. Her father, who was always supportive and believed his daughter could do great things, also very unusual for the time, took her to the local priest to help her decide. Depending on who you believe, the priest either raved on about the sin and seedy people surrounding the opera and told her she'd have more time for devotions as a painter, or simply pointed out that painting, though the harder path, was probably the more rewarding one for her. In any case, she did choose painting, and this is how she viewed her teenage struggle 40 years later. 40 years later? Yes. This was painted when Kauffman was in her 50s, at the height of her international fame. So how does she see this choice with the benefit of hindsight? Apparently, it's not a choice at all. The title gives us this clue, self-portrait of the artist hesitating between the arts. Her choice is already made. Her whole body turns toward painting, but she glances back as Music implores her to stay. This pose is called contrapposto and is found everywhere in classical art, looking back while turning away. So often our choices are like this. We already know which road we'd like to take, but we hesitate. It's harder, it's less certain, it's more dangerous. For Kauffman, being a painter in a man's world, even a talented one, would come with challenges she might not face in the opera, where women were already established. Competing with men for commissions was never going to be easy, especially in her preferred genre of history painting, the highest and most noble kind of painting at the time. But she had to try. And here's proof of success. She portrays her struggle in a history painting, showing figures of the muses, ancient architecture, and classical poses. Well played, Angelica. Not every choice in our lives is like this. Sometimes we genuinely don't know what to do. But I think it's more common for us to know what way our heart pulls us and then hesitate. Kauffman implores us to be brave. Don't play it safe. Go for the glory, she seems to say. I hope Angelica's teenage angst has brightened your day and inspired you to go for it, whatever it is. As always, I've put links in the description box below if you'd like to know more about Kauffman or this painting specifically. And take care of yourselves. Listen to your heart. I'll see you next time.